So in this video, we will write our own strlen function. So don't include the string.h in order not to have some errors with the names. So we want to make a function that returns the number of the characters in a string. So int strlen, and this function takes a string, right? So something like this. Now, if you include the string.h, you will get an error that you are defining the same function that is already defined in string.h, okay? Now over here, in order to count how many characters we have, for example, in this string over here, we will iterate over the characters. So start with the first one. So is this \0? The answer is no. So increase the count. Is this \0? No, increase the count. Is this \0? No, increase the count. And this will continue until we reach \0. So when we reach \0, we don't increase the count and we exit. So it's very easy, as you'll see in a little bit. So let's iterate over the elements. So int I equal 0. And the condition over here is that the character that we are at is not equal to \0, right? So we have something like this. Str sub I is not equal to \0. So if the character that we are at is not \0, we will execute the loop and we want to increase I each time. So in here, let's say we have a variable called count and we want to increment it like this. Now let's define this variable, int count, initialize it to 0. And after we exit the loop, we want to return this count. So let's have an example. Let's take this one over here. So count is equal to 0. Now, int I is equal to 0. Str sub I, first of all, is str sub 0. So what's str sub 0 over here? It's actually \0 because we have no characters. It is an empty string. So the first character of this string is actually \0. So we can verify this. Let me comment this. And over here, I'll make a string which is equal to an empty string. And now printf, we want to print an integer, which is the following condition. So str sub 0 is equal to \0, like this. So now run the program, and as you can see, we have 1. So this is true. And by the way, I just noticed I'm missing my %d all over here. So let's add them. Okay, now let's remove this code. So back to this example, str sub 0 is not different than \0. So this loop will no longer execute and we will exit it, and here we will return count, which is equal to 0. So this over here gives us 0, and this is true. Now let's see this example. So count is equal to 0. Str sub 0 is different than \0. This is A. So we execute the body. So count plus plus. Now count is equal to 1. So I plus plus. Str sub 1 is also different than \0. It is L. So count plus plus. Now count is equal to 2. So I plus plus. Str sub 2 is also different than \0. It is I. So now count is equal to 3. I plus plus. Now str sub I is not different than \0. As you see, the character after I is \0. And C automatically puts it because C is creating this string. Okay. And by the way, this is called C string literal. Okay. So as you can see, this condition is no longer true. So we exit the loop and we return count, and count is equal to 3. So this over here gives us 3, and it is also true. And the same happens with the rest of the examples. So let's build and run this program. As you see, we have 0, 3, 6, and this is true, and we have 10, and this is also true. So congratulations, you wrote your own strlen. So this is it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one.